Basic, gonna dance to it. Basic, everywhere, gonna dance to it. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today, we've got a team that's been great at defending the pass. The Cowboys are top 10 at defending the pass, and they'll be going up against the Packers, who will need to solve that secondary.
All right, we appreciate it, Larry. It's our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Between the Green Bay Packers and the Dallas Cowboys. In motion left here, one of their tight ends. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And able to use his blockers to get this up over the 40. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
On second down, Elliott, and he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
They go play action here on first down. Flush to his right. And some room to roam now. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Now a play fake here on first down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Elliott. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. Call it a pickup of 7, and it'll bring up a second down. Elliott, and he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral, also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Play action now, Prescott. Steps away to his left. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Williams. And down inside the 15 he goes. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. Yeah, the movement there coming from the middle of the line.
And you understand he wants to get off the ball quickly, but the ball's right in front of him. He has to watch it move first.
So following the penalty, now first and 5. After the penalty, it's Elliott. And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. Call it a gain of a couple there as it'll leave him with a second and just three.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
And they'll send the tight end in motion left. They go to Elliott again. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and two.
Now that was a good job by the defense swarming to the football. And you know it's no cinch that you're going to be able to get the ball into the end zone against them. They're number two against the run. So what's an offensive coordinator to do? Check your playlist.
And this will be play number eight of the opening drive. It's third and short. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And not going to be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. And Bailey able to knock it through. And the Cowboys are going to jump out to a 3-0 lead. So the opening drive for them here on their home turf results in a field goal.
Now that's the way you want to get things started. Your stadium, your crowd, you've got the ball. Put points on the board first and let everyone start to celebrate.
Here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Well, we know that the identity of this offense is to throw the ball. They've got to run it every so often, if for no other reason than to tamp down the pass rush. They can't let them just tee off and get to their quarterback.
Nelson, the man in motion right. Throwing on second down. Going underneath for Gordon. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Now he steps away. Room here to run. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
So that'll back him up five. Here's Gordon. And some room to work. And oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back at the 46. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And he's going to be wrapped up and driven down. Tyrone Crawford. with a big-time sack on third down. And it'll be a loss of seven. On fourth down, here's Justin Vogel on to punt it away. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in the contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in the contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
A second down throw for Prescott. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, big hit right around the 31. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. Fresh set of downs here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stats.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Prescott now on second down. Room to run past midfield. He's got the connection to Cole Beasley. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
Things for sure. When you've got a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you got to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. Throwing again. Prescott on second and 10. Bryant with a catch right side. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Extend their lead. Dan Bailey now for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. He kick this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Caught left side, Bennett. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Nice job. Nice patience right there. Put him on the right side. Let him work his way across. Put the ball in his hands and let him work his way upfield with a catch.
Now Gordon on first down. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. Call it a loss of 6 on the play. And it'll make this a second and long. And they'll get him to the ground, but he got all the way down to the 30-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Rodgers now on first down. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Cobb. And he is out of bounds, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. That's complete right around the 8. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
On second down, they'll run with Gordon. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
Rodgers going to try and throw on third down. That is caught by Cobb. And it's a Packer touchdown. Randall Cobb, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Packers have cut it back within a score. Crosby on now to kick it away. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
They start on the ground with Elliott. And he'll wind up with about 6, up past the 30 to the 31.
Let's talk a little football 101 here because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
Again, it's Elliott. And this time not as successful, as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a third and about three to go. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. That's taken on the 25. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. A first scoring update now from Carolina. And it's the Panthers there out to the early advantage. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. He'll start the drive with a run by Gordon. And he'll be out of bounds, able to take it down to the 40. That good for 19 and a first down.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of their yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. First down, Rodgers. And he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49. Paul Posluszny in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. On second down, here's Rodgers. Let's it fly deep for Cobb. That's caught inside the 20. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A gain of 32 that time. Into the red zone. It's Rodgers. His throw caught right around the 6. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. First and goal, Melvin Gordon. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here. This close, sneak it.
I don't think you even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
Try and punch it in, Gordon. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. And prior to this third and two play, we're going to get a timeout call as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Stonewalled on second down. Now let's see what they can do on third and goal from the 2. Now they send a man in motion right. Rodgers looking to throw on third and two. In trouble, and he'll go down back at the 12. Tyrone Crawford in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through. Okay, so Larry apparently giving us the silent treatment all of a sudden, and we're going to skip ahead to quarter number three. Meanwhile, a second quarter score from Carolina, and it's the Panthers there out to the early advantage. And we'll keep you abreast of how that one shakes out. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. They'll start the third quarter on the ground with Gordon. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Second down of the offense in search of 6 yards. They keep it on the ground. Again, Gordon. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Now a 10th carry for Melvin Gordon. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
Now they'll throw with Rodgers. Throw left side complete. It's Gordon. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. The left side throw complete to Adams. The ball comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
Now I have to admit, partner, that I've often thought that I don't like this rule, where the offensive player fumbles the ball, it goes out of bounds, and they get to keep it.
That's just because you're a defensive guy. That's why you don't like it.
Yeah, you're right. It is a slanted view, isn't it?
But this is where, for the offensive team, the sideline is their friend. Usually it's not their friend.
Yeah, exactly right. I actually played for a guy in college. You know what he used to name the sideline? Sammy. Sammy sideline, and use him well.
Rodgers gives this to Jamal Williams. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Call it a gain of a couple there, as it'll leave him with a 2nd and just 3.
Not a whole lot there after the penalty, but remember, it was 1st and 5, not 1st and 10. So now they can keep grinding out first downs, and good things can happen for them. Just 2nd and short coming up.
3 yards remaining here on 2nd down. Defense showing blitz. They fake the give. Now Rodgers. Flushed out right. And that is incomplete here. He was out there waving his arms saying, throw it here. Dropped it. Not a good look.
Well, all I can do is just look at him with contempt on that one. As a defensive back, I'm saying, not as an announcer. Just like, really?
A little bit of a diva look, isn't it?
Yeah, very much so, because I think what happens is he just had too much time to think. He's wide open now. Here comes the ball, and he doesn't concentrate and drops it.
A good chance. This is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a third and three. Here's Rodgers, and he can't quite pick it. No interception so far. That probably should have been their first, but at least it's fourth down. Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to go for it on four. They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. Escaping the pressure right. This is Cobb with a catch right side. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. Give him 16 yards on the play. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. So here we go, first and 10 now. Now a handoff. This is Gordon. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back at the 15-yard line. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. And this seemingly endless drive continues. In motion right comes Cobb. They go back to Gordon here on first down. And this carry terminated at the 8-yard line. Good stick skill showing the power, but just not much room to operate. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a second and 3. Shift together here from the D-line. Rodgers to throw on second down. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Randall Cobb with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Packers have taken the lead. Oh, how about this? No good. Just his second miss of the year. And our score will stay right where it is. Crosby on now to kick it away. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, to something to get you off to a quick start.
Oh, he's got a little daylight. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. A tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the fourth overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact types of runs.
They go play action here on first down. Drops it underneath to Elliott. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
First down carry by Elliott. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. Flush to his right. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ross Cockrell. And he'll return this one just shy of midfield to the 49.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage. But instead, he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
Elsewhere, they have gone to the second half in Carolina. Now, you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. They'll try and get the ground game going. Here's Gordon. A gain of 3, second down. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action, hit them over the top.
Now Rodgers throwing on second down. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. Touchdown, Packers! Devontae Adams, his 9th touchdown of the season. And that interception key as it leads to the touchdown.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post-grab?
Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10.
Well, they tried to get 2 and ended up getting none because the quarterback had nowhere to go with the ball and ends up getting sacked.
Nowhere to go at all. Great job, though, defensively. They were ready. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part 2, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
If they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. 2nd down following the run. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So they jumped on the left side of that line.
And you know, when you're at the end spot, you are like in the starting blocks, waiting for the pistol to fire and go, and he jumped a little bit too early.
From the pistol, here's Elliott. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2.
Man, these guys may not win this ball game, but you certainly can't fault the effort of this man here today. He's been a real thorn in their sides all afternoon, and that last carry puts him over the 100-yard mark.
They'll try to throw now. Prescott. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now the offense lining up first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Got a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And he motions the wide receiver. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-round pick, Demarius Randall. Pass the 20, and they will score. It's a Packer touchdown. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth-quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
And his kick is good. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And he'll get about three as he takes this up near the 25.
Defenses always talk about earning the right to rush the passer on third down. And you know what offenses want? Win first down so that can set things up for themselves better.
And that wasn't helpful there. Not a big impact on first down. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. A dump off to Elliott. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. So the offense has it first and 10. Again to Elliott. And now running right through it. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. Forced out to his left. Out left side here to Bryant. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. And a long way to go for the offense here on second down. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. Eluding the pressure right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. On third down, That's Elliott. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up fourth down.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Blake Martinez. And he'll bring it all the way back, just a yard or two shy of midfield. So now he's equaled his interception total from a week ago. Remember, Charles, he had three last week.
And you know, all week long, he vowed to take that number down. Told the guys on the team, don't worry, things are going to pick up. I've got this. But he is in a major league rut right now. Let's see if his teammates can pick him up along the way.
You're right. He talked about being cool, calm, collective, rebounding. Not rebounding right here. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
20! And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Melvin Gordon with touchdown number 8 on the year. And that interception key as it leads to the touchdown. And the lead will grow by one more. Crosby on now to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. And out now come the Cowboys. And 3 interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number 4 is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw 4.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown 3, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Cole Beasley, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Call it a gain of 3, and that's going to bring up a third down. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Here's Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now, because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
Prescott looks to throw on first. Complete to right. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. A first down throw for Prescott. He hits Beasley right side. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. They'll run with D'Angelo Henderson. And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Prescott now on second down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Elliott. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. The Cowboys on third down. 2 for 5 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 2. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. He's got his man, it's Williams. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Terrence Williams, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys cut into that lead. And that'll make this a 19-point game. Now to kick this one away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They come into enemy territory, and I don't care what the matchup is in the National Football League. You're up like this late in the game on the road. This feels pretty good.
Oh, it feels fantastic. Anytime you get a road victory in the NFL, that's a big-time accomplishment. And to do it this convincingly, that just tears up the script that every home team has, which is nobody comes into our house and pushes us around. They took care of business today.
Yeah, they pushed around, and now the final stages of this one. 1st down and 10 now for the offensive group. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. This is Gordon as they go to him again. And he might have got this across midfield, not by much. They'll mark it down at the 49. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly. 88.
Another tote for Gordon. He's been busy this afternoon. And they'll get him down here at about the 42. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a 3rd and 1 situation. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on 2nd down.
Yeah, pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know true north.
Oh my goodness.
Smiling with 50 carats in my jaw.
Oh my goodness.
The law, it's a shame, rhyme.
It's a shame they let us jump out of Bentleys with dirty vans. Hit the stage for 15 minutes, get 30 bands. Swiss bank counting clean money with dirty hands. With some hood that's ready to